In contrast to the previous presentation on small industrial projects, the next one addresses the successful delivery of mega projects. Research Team 315 will highlight the need to improve mega project planning and execution performance and introduce the MPACT tool, a resource for assessing and mitigating critical impact factors on mega projects. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Ronnie Stephens, Director of Project Success and PLC for the Williams Companies.
As resources become constrained, as global population demands increase, as infrastructure deteriorates, the size and complexity of capital projects has continued to grow. The prevailing term for these very large efforts is mega projects. It would seem that traditional project management techniques would be sufficient to keep mega projects on track. Research confirms this is not the case. With so much at stake, what changes in project planning and execution are needed to increase the likelihood of mega project success?
Good morning and welcome to Boston. My name is Ronnie Stephens, and based on the headlines and the data we just reviewed, it would seem like getting assigned to a mega project is at times an impossible mission. And while we didn't have Tom Cruise working with us, we did have some industry superstars on Research Team 315, the successful delivery of mega project. This team has developed some great tools and resources, which is why I'm here today to talk about them. I wanted to start by going through our research question, which is, what changes in project planning and execution are needed to increase the likelihood of mega project success? And for our team, we defined a mega project as any capital project with its total installed cost greater than $1 billion and with any of the following complexity criteria. And for those of you who don't work on projects that meet this threshold, we feel our research could still be applied to your company's largest and most complex projects. So why is this important to most of you who are here today? Based on literature reviews, it is estimated that close to $57 trillion will be spent on infrastructure projects in the next 15 years. And if those projects perform on the conservative side of the industry average, then approximately 30% overspending will occur, which is an additional $17 trillion, for a total expected expenditure of $74 trillion. But what if we could improve performance by just 5%? That would be an additional savings of $3.7 trillion over the next 15 years, or close to $250 billion per year. How many of us in the room could get excited about that kind of opportunity? I know I sure could. So now I'm going to introduce a video that's going to illustrate how our research could be utilized. Let's watch and see.
Good job, guys. This has been a very successful project for us.
Thank you, Jolene. As a team, we were able to deliver this very complex project on time and on budget while maintaining our quality and safety standards.
I agree. This was a very tough project. I was surprised that we were able to start up on time. Tell me one thing. We've worked on many other mega projects, but most of them experienced significant overruns to cost and schedule. What was different this time?
I think our success can be attributed to the team assessing the challenges on this project and planning their mitigation together.
How? What was the secret?
So, before I get to the secret, let me explain the tools and the process that we went through. We started by doing a literature review, and then we conducted preliminary interviews on 20 mega projects. We used that data then to come up with detailed surveys and follow-up interviews on 76 projects, 41 of which were mega projects. We then went and created 7 detailed case studies that involved a mix of both successful and unsuccessful mega projects. The key findings that we had were that we identified and prioritized 34 critical factors that impact the successful delivery of the mega projects, and we grouped them into 5 categories. And most importantly, we developed an implementation resource, 315-2, which is the Mega Project Assessment of Criticality Tool, or MPACT for short, which is an easy-to-use Excel-based tool. Our implementation resource contains in-depth information on the factor's occurrence and impact levels. It talks about the probable causes and potential outcomes of those factors. We also go into real case examples that the project team can use, along with providing recommendations so that if they do occur on your project, you can hopefully plan and even better yet, mitigate these factors on your team. So now let's go back to the video and see just what was the secret that they found.
Well, there's no secret to it. 5 years ago, when we were planning this project, CII introduced an assessment tool built around factors that occur more often and have higher impact on mega projects. I was fortunate to be there when CII launched it. I immediately wanted to apply it to this project, and it's been a major success factor.
Yes, I have heard about this being used. Tell me more about it. How are mega project teams using it?
Okay.
Research Team 315 has prepared an Excel-based assessment tool called the Mega Project Assessment of Criticality Tool, or MPACT for short. MPACT provides in-depth information to help project teams understand critical impact factors and their associated consequences. It is a synthesis of all the key findings from the research to produce a library of knowledge detailing these factors. The tool has been designed to raise understanding, highlight the importance, provide case study examples, and provide recommendations on how to mitigate these impact factors.
I think we can use this on our project. It might be helpful.
I agree. Let's attend the implementation session. Wow, that session was informative. The research team did a great job explaining the tool.
The biggest benefit I see from the assessment is the early recognition and planning around elements that are missing from other traditional scope definition tools. MPACT also extends the factor assessment to the execution phase, unlike PDRI.
Yes, that's true. By using MPACT, we can do more accurate and thorough mitigation planning on these impact factors.
Yeah, the descriptions, case study examples, and recommendations really add great value.
I agree. Now that we've been introduced to MPACT, let's use it on the Mayfair refining project.
So, just like was demonstrated in the video, I would like to invite you all to attend our implementation session today to learn valuable information that I'm sure will be talked about for years. Our implementation session is going to be going on in the Grand Ballroom, J&K, at 11 and 1 p.m. And if you're unable to attend our implementation session, you can still download our resource materials from either the CII app on your mobile device or by logging on to CII.com. Additionally, we'll also be handling out USB drives in our implementation session with all the resources that you need. But before I conclude, I would like to personally thank all the members of Research Team 315 shown on the screen behind me for all their hard work and dedication these last 2.5 years. You're an amazing team, and I have been honored to work with each of you. And for the rest of you here in attendance, if you truly want to unlock the secret to project success and you don't know when to end up as just another headline in a movie, then I have one thing left just to say to you. Your mission, should you choose to accept it, is to attend our implementation session today. This message will self-destruct in 5 seconds. Thank you.